现在时间点是2015年，是今天的第四段了。因为现在讲到乌菲兹，那个意大利的佛罗伦斯的乌菲兹美术馆，我们来看看哦。现在小宋在外面说话不太方便，录音也许吧，待会看看结果效果如何。
The Medici family ruled Florence from this grand palace, the Palazzo Vecchio. Their offices, or Uffizi, were next door.Now these offices hold the finest collection of Italian paintings anywhere, the Uffizi Gallery. Each day here in
这是乌菲兹走廊。
Throughout Europe, frustrated tourists who don't study their guidebooks waste precious hours in museum lines. Meanwhile, travelers who made a reservation by phone or purchased the city museum pass as we did are allowed right in.The Uffizi's collection, displayed on one comfortable floor, takes you on a sweep through Italian art history from the 12th through the 17th century.
从12世纪到17世纪的艺术家杰作。
Gilded Gothic altarpieces, like this Annunciation by the Sienese.
瑟特克高歌德一直到文艺复兴这段时间。
Master Simone Martini must have dazzled the faithful in the 1300s.The stars of the Florentine class of 1500 are all here. Leonardo da Vinci's Annunciation is exquisite.
这是就是报喜图要怎么讲？就是圣母受孕，然后天使报喜 Annunciation. 这是文艺复兴的好几个大师的杰作喽。但我们看到那个拉斐尔等等的大师级作品。
Michelangelo's Holy Family shows he can do.
米开朗基罗的圣家族。
More than carved statues, and Raphael considered a synthesis of them.
是啊，这是拉斐尔的画像。
Power of Michelangelo and the grace of Leonardo captures a delicate moment in his Madonna of the Goldfinch. And the collection follows art after the Renaissance with masterpieces like Parmigianino's Slippery Lady with the Long Neck.For me, the Uffizi, like Florence itself, is all about the thrilling leap from medieval to modern, as happened when Europe moved from Gothic to Renaissance. These altarpieces are Gothic. Being pre-Renaissance, they simply tell their story through symbolism rather than realism. The gold.
这些作品是象征性大于写实性。
Leaf sky isn't realistic, but it implies a rich and holy setting.The angels are stacked like a totem pole.
它呈现东西就好像是图腾柱一样 ，totem pole.
Flanking this cross, panels like painted pages tell the story of the crucifixion, but with little sense of depth.
是耶稣的受难像被钉在十字架上面受洗。
Yet artists were trying.To show Jesus' head leaning out, it actually does. Giotto, while still Gothic, is often considered the.
是啊，这边提到一个非常有名的艺术家，叫做乔托 Giotto。有机会了，我们看看他 Giotto 在那个是哪比萨还是哪边？啊，托斯卡尼那附近呢？托斯卡尼那有一幅乔托在教堂里画的那个是啊彗星的图，是彗星是 comet 是那个是。史上在欧洲历史上第一次被画出来，画在那个壁画上，壁画是在教堂里面。
First modern painter, notice the progress. His more realistic setting places Mary and baby Jesus on a throne, occupying a believable space.
是乔托的这个圣母圣子图，他把圣母圣子画在一个非常大的空间里面，是前所未见。
The kneeling angels in front and peekaboo saints behind create an illusion of depth. If the Renaissance was the foundation of our modern world, a foundation for the Renaissance was classical art. Sculptors, painters.
如果说那个文艺复兴是现代艺术的先驱，那么古典艺术就是文艺复兴的先驱喽。
And poets alike turn to ancient work for inspiration. 2,000-year-old Roman and Greek statues like these decorated gardens of the wealthy.
这些杰作就是灵感来自于古希腊罗马2000年的历史传承，指的是艺术形式上面，还有精神。
This ancient art was considered the epitome of beauty. Kings made copies of it. Napoleon stole his favorite pieces. And in the 19th century, young aristocrats on the Grand Tour came here and swooned.During the Renaissance, as in the ancient world, people saw the glory of God in the beauty, order, and harmony of the human body. God's greatest creation. Classical statues clearly inspired Sandro Botticelli. For me, his Birth of Venus is the purest expression of Renaissance beauty.
Botticelli 的维纳斯诞生。
The goddess of love, born from the foam of a wave, is just waking up.Botticelli combines the beauty of nature and the human body. The hands, wings, and robe mingle with the wind. With Venus's flyaway hair, the airy spaciousness of the distant horizon, and the flowers caught at the peak of their beauty tumbling in slow motion, the world itself is fresh and newborn. Botticelli's Primavera, or springtime, shows the Renaissance finally in full bloom.
这是 Botticelli 的另外一幅杰作，跟那个维纳斯诞生齐名的，它好像是四季，是不是？还是说四个季节？忘记了，它是四个连环的那个系列。我们继续看看好了。
The warm winds blow in, causing Flora to sprout flowers from her lips. Meanwhile, the figure of spring spreads petals from her dress. The three graces dance.A blindfolded Cupid happily sprays his little arrows. And in the center stands a fertile Venus, the classical goddess of love.
Go, Zhong Long.